Do you want to shuffle these, Brady, just so people are happy that they're not in a prearranged order?
Oh, I'm sure people believe us, but there we go. I've shuffled them up a bit. And...
No, I can't do that either. So I'm not attempting to do it on camera. Right, so we've got a randomly shuffled pack of cards. I don't know the order they're in. And I'm just going to memorise them. So I'm just going to deal them out and then try and remember where they're red, black, and then we'll go for it. Okay, let's go. Go for it. Black, 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 red, black, 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 red, red, oops, black, red, red, black, red, black, red, black, black, red, black, black, red, black, red, 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 red. 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 Black. 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 Red. Black. Red. Red, black, red, red, black, black, black. Final four. Red, black, red, red. Yay!
You happy with that?
I'm very happy with that.
Well done. Very well done.
Whew, phew, genuine relief.
Well done.
I think quite a few people watching might have spotted what I was doing based on the gaps I was leaving. So when I was reciting them in particular, I was I wasn't reciting them at a consistent pace. So I'd maybe, I think I'd do kind of six and then I'd often think for a bit and then I'd do the next six. So I think that was a little bit of a clue that I'm grouping these cards into six, so groups of six. And I'll just give you an example. So the first one, now I've got to remember it was, the first one was, the first six was black and then black, and then black, and then it was black again, and then it was red, and then it was black. So that was my first group of six. What I'm doing is I'm taking the second to the sixth of that group of six, and I am, if it's a black card, I'm thinking about a one in my head, and if it's a red card, I'm thinking about a zero in my head. And so actually what I'm doing is I'm turning that set of five into binary. So this is a binary number, a string of ones and zeros. And then I'm turning that binary number into base 10 in my head. So in binary, this represents one lot of one, zero lots of two, and one lot of four. And then I've got one lot of eight, and then I've got one lot of 16. So this is 29. So this binary number represents 29. So I'm then remembering 29. So essentially I've condensed those five digits into this two-digit number.
What about that first number?
That's a good question. So this first one is in my head. Sometimes I remember black as a negative and red as a positive, and sometimes I just remember it as black or red. So essentially I found that I was much quicker and much more fluent if I just dealt with five digit binary numbers. As soon as I got to the sixth digit, I was like, was it 37? Was it 27? I was getting really confused. So I found it easier to think about that bit of information just as it is, as like black or red. So for each of these groups, it's either black or red. And sometimes in my head, I imagine the number as black or red. So literally this is black pen 29. But then occasionally when I've been practicing, I've been remembering it as minus 29. So it changes. But this, just to be clear, this isn't signed binary, right? So this is literally just this is the binary number, and then this is just a separate bit of information. So I had black 29, the next one I had was black 25, and then the next one, I know you're asking me, was red 10, I think, and then the next one was black 22, and then the next one was black 0, which was really nice. That was quite a gift. And then the next one was red, and it was 3, I think. And then the next one was black again. A lot of them were black, which is really helpful, so I only had 2 reds here. And that was black 20, I think. And then it was black 7. Each of these are 6, and there's 8 of them, so that's 48 cards only. So the final 4, I'm just remembering as what they are. There's only sort of like not many patterns you can have with 4 cards, and it was red, black, red, red. So I just, in my head, I remember that as the second one is black. So that's what I was remembering. So essentially 8 1 or 2 digit numbers, a bunch of blacks and reds.
What's harder, the encoding or the decoding afterwards?
Actually neither. So I guess there's 3 processes. The first process is encoding, so turning it into the base 10 number. Second process is just remembering it, and then decoding. Encoding and decoding, I've just practiced lots and lots, so I'm really quick at it, so that's not too hard, it's still remembering. It's kind of trying to encode in one part of your brain whilst at the same time not forgetting all of the numbers that have already come through, and the patterns. So as I say, this was quite a nice one, because I'm not going to do my trick down, but the fact that we've only got 2 reds, and they had this kind of symmetry, so I see it like this in my head. So I see I've got 8 things to remember, plus these little extra ones.
Black 0, is that a black card and then all reds?
Yeah, exactly. So that was a black card and then 5 reds. So that was just really nice. Like, I probably smiled when I dealt that out. So if you see on the, that was nice. And then also then, in order to remember the numbers, often, there's not too many patterns in this one, but often if there's a pattern, that helps me remember it. So the other day I was practicing and I had something like 14 and then 7, and that's half. Or another one I did the other day, I had 20 and then 3 and then 17, and 20 take 3 is 17. So if I can spot little patterns like that while I'm going along, that really helps me remember it.
It almost feels like it would be easier just to remember the 52 cards.
Definitely not. Like, I think the key with this is that I'm condensing the information. So base 10 is much more efficient than binary. So this is effectively binary, right? So black reds are the same as binary. And so I'm condensing like 6 or 5 digits down to 1 or 2 digits.
If you have a brain for numbers and you're about to start university, well, this could be your moment. Our episode sponsor, Jane Street, is running its Academy of Math and Programming. It's a 5-week summer program for recent high school graduates, particularly those who've experienced barriers to access and opportunity. It's happening in July, and all the expenses are paid, including accommodation, travel, and they're throwing in a $5,000 scholarship to support future opportunities. If you're interested, or maybe you know someone who might be, check out the details on the Jane Street website. All your questions will be answered there, and I've also put a link in the video description. Our thanks to Jane Street for their support.
And people have said, oh, why don't you use hexadecimal? Because you can represent 8 digits, 8 bits with just like 2 digits, but I'm just nowhere near as practiced in that. So it would be so much more difficult for me to remember things.